Now, Senamile Masango is South Africa's first black female nuclear physicist, and she joins us to tell us more about the Wise Africa NGO, which provides leadership to young people wishing to enter the fields of science and technology. Welcome back to Afternoon Express.
Hi, Jenny. Thank you so much for inviting me.
I love having you here because you are basically the most... You're essentially the most intelligent woman in the country.
No. I'm a hard worker. I'm not a straight A student. I work hard.
But that's such an inspiring message, I think, for all of these girls in the country that are watching today, watching you today, to know that anything you can do in your life, you can do if you do work hard. I mean, you're a nuclear physicist.
Yes, I am a nuclear physicist.
Tell everyone, what does a nuclear physicist do?
A nuclear physicist, some they can do applications, but I'm in the theoretical side, so I study the nucleus itself. So I don't want to go there because it's too abstract and very intense.
Why is it important for women to get involved in the science faculty?
It is very important so that young people can contribute towards this, to provide solution in our country. Because South Africa, we are consumers instead of producers. So if we involve young people who are passionate to contribute towards the economy of our country, so that one is also very important. And about you, Wise Africa, what we do in Wise Africa, we provide leadership and role models for young people, especially to the disadvantaged communities.
So Wise is your NGO, so it's science and engineering in Africa. So why did you start it?
I started it because when I started my undergrad degree, I had no mentor, I had no role model. So I made a lot of mistakes. Imagine a young girl, I started my undergrad while I was 16 years old, so I was not responsible back then. So I want to fill the gap, and I also want to take science to the rural communities, because rural girls, they don't have any hope, and girls are being discouraged at the early age not to take science subject because it's too difficult for them. So I want to change the perception around science. I want young people to stop seeing science as a problem, but see science as something that they can use to solve their own problems.
You know, I interviewed this lady, and I'm sure you know her. She's the first black female chancellor at UCT. And she said to me, if you tell somebody when they're young that science is hard, maths is hard, then they're going to grow up believing that it's hard.
It's a mental problem.
But if that's not in your story, if you don't tell somebody that it's hard and you can't do it, then it just becomes another subject and it becomes achievable and, and doable.
Yes, it's what I do usually. I go to school and encourage them. I'm from a rural area. I didn't attend a Model C school. I attend also a government school. And I'm from Gwanongoma, which is a deep rural area. So if Senamile can do it, they can also do it themselves.
And I mean, of course, she's not only, in my opinion, the most intelligent person I know, but you're also friends with our prayers now. Tell me.
No,
how
I'm
is
not.
Our fabulous prayer? I love old Cyril. So, how is Cyril doing?
Okay. So I'm passionate about education. And no one chooses to be pure. Everyone in South Africa deserves a quality education. So that is what I've been advocating for. So I told our president that they must invest more in education, because no one chooses to be poor. And again, as young people, we have responded to the call to make education fashionable. So we want to contribute something in our economy. It's highly time in South Africa where we must be producers, not consumers at all the time. And again, we must produce more of our own PhD graduates who are ready for the fourth industrial revolution.
So how was it received? What did he say to you when you told him that?
He said, we have to meet. I'm still waiting for his call.
Oh, well, from your lips to God's ears, I think that is an amazing thing to tell him.
Yes.
When are you going to see him again?
I don't know. I'm just waiting for his call.
Oh, that is amazing.
He's a busy man, so I'm just waiting for his call.
But he lives up the road, so we'll pop in for a drink after work if you want. So I think that is such an important point. Make education fashionable.
Yes, you must make
because
education.
It is fashionable. It is cool. When you are educated, when you are smart, when you're successful, there's no better fashion than that, my friend.
And education is key to sustainable development.
Exactly. Thank you so much for being here again. It's always so lovely to see you.
Thank you so much.